cook prepare as many biscuits as he can this morning. And perhaps we might move a few extra chairs into the drawing room too. Well, I do wonder which gentleman will be the very first to call. I have so much to ask of them all.
Well, let us get you dressed.
Anthony, I did not expect to see you here this morning.
It is terribly early for you, dearest.
You could not sleep for some reason. All the excitement, I presume. Am I the first gentleman to arrive? How wonderful.
Callers, ma'am. The Earl of Stafford and the Marquis of Finlay.
Your word! Well, you should have my colourful fashions to thank.
For a Miss Marina Thompson?
Dearest reader, this author finds herself compelled to share the most curious of news.
And do you have a large family too, my lord?
It seems our diamond requires a closer inspection.
Is there a problem, Lord Bridgerton?
I should think so. You are in my seat.
As such, an even rarer jewel of only the most remarkable brilliance, fire, and luster has been unearthed. Her name, unknown to most, yet soon known to all, is Miss Marina Thompson.
Should you not be out on your daily walk about the square, dear?
It appears as though it may rain.
This author is left to wonder whether Her Majesty might reconsider the high praise she once afforded Miss Bridgerton. For we all must know what the Queen despises more than anything: being wrong. And the drawing room at Bridgerton House currently appears to be emptier than the muddled head of her dearest King George.